Hello everyone, I am Bishwapriyo Das from Nanoscale Device Research Laboratory of DAC Department IISc, and I am going to discuss briefly about the article titled An Atom to Circuit Modeling Approach to All 2D Metal Insulator Semiconductor Field Effect Transistor that recently got published in Nature Partner Journal 2D Materials and Applications. I'll start with a systematic overview and workflow of the whole multiscale modeling framework vividly described through this flowchart. There are three levels of abstractions in this work, that is materials, device and circuit. We have first carried out the density functional theory calculations of the van der Waals heterostructure comprising of graphene, two layers of HBN and molybdenum disulfide. Here graphene works as the gate electrode of the metal insulator semiconductor structure. HBN works as the 2D insulator and MOS2 works as the 2D semiconducting material. From DFT calculations, we first obtain the band structure parameters such as effective mass and energies at band extrema and thereafter use them to develop a compact device model of the MISFET. The resulting terminal charge and the current data are then fed to the SPICE engine via Verilog AMS interface to conduct static and transient analysis of the digital circuits made out of these MISFETs. Although in this work the mobility value of MOS2 was taken from a reference, one can calculate it from the first principle based methods. The most important parameter in this regard is the deformation potential. One can obtain the low field mobility from the knowledge of the deformation potential of the acoustic phonons, and in general, after obtaining the deformation potentials for both the acoustic and optical phonons, one can obtain the field dependent mobility profile by solving Boltzmann transport equation using Monte Carlo method and then calibrate it to the Coge-Thomas model. Another approach to calculate mobility is using the Landauer transport formalism in conjunction with the molecular dynamics simulation as referred in this reference. Here, the atomic configuration of the graphene HBN MOS2 van der Waals heterostructure is shown along with the equilibrium interlayer spacing between the different layers. In this work, we have varied the interlayer spacing, that is D1, from 3.0 angstrom to 3.4 angstrom, and also varied the doping concentration in MOS2 layer to assess the transistor performance of device, circuit level. The various model parameters obtained from DFT calculations are presented in this table. Now, our model is generic in nature and it encompasses many subtle and intricate atomic level phenomena, out of which the band gap opening in graphene is most crucial, that dictates the transistor performance. When graphene is placed on top of HBN in Bernal stacking order, then due to this stacking pattern, the on-site energies of CB and C0 atoms become different and a net charge transfer occurs from C0 to CB atom, and thus the chemical equivalence of the carbon lattice site is broken. It can be quantified using the Mulliken population analysis as shown in the table. Here delta Q is the net charge transfer per atom, and it is clearly visible that the charge transfer is more prominent when D1 decreases. This sublattice symmetry breaking can be parameterized by a mass term which results into this tight binding Hamiltonian as shown here, thereby producing this energy dispersion relation. Here we get the energy dispersion relation, that is E of k as plus minus root over of delta square plus h cut v f k whole square. Here the band gap Eg equal to 2 delta, that is 2 m star into v f square, that can be easily formulated using simple laws of physics, and it converts into the original linear dispersion of graphene when delta becomes zero. Now this is the composite band structure of the aforesaid van der Waals heterostructure. Here the red bands are of graphene and blue bands are of MOS2. It is seen that the band gap opening increases with decreasing D1 due to more on-site energy difference between the carbon lattice sites. But graphene remains effectively undoped in this case and only becomes N or P type depending upon the doping in MOS2 as shown in the band structure. In all the five cases, MOS2 has an unaltered band gap of 1.71 electron volt, but MOS2 becomes more p-type with decreasing D1, and thus the threshold voltage of the device is expected to increase. To gain more insight regarding the interlayer charge transfer at the atomic level, we have calculated the electron density difference. Clearly, from the plot and the numeric values of the area under EDD, the charge redistribution is more pronounced at the graphene HBN interface rather than HBN-HBN or HBN-MOS2 interfaces, and it increases at graphene HBN interface with decreasing D1, which remains almost unaltered at other two interfaces. When D1 less than 3.2 angstrom, the surface charge repulsion dictates on the graphene HBN interface, and for D1 greater than 3.2 angstrom, an accumulation region indicates the presence of strong orbital hybridization between graphene and HBN. It originates from the interaction between the pz orbitals of carbon atoms, which are susceptible to be perturbed by the interactions from the pi electron clouds of nitrogen atoms of HBN. But this orbital hybridization is less prominent in HBN-MOS2 interface because of the contribution of d orbitals of molybdenum atoms to the band structure, whose interactions with s or p orbitals are very limited. But interestingly, there is a dipole formation at the MOS2 HBN interface, which in turn causes work function modification, signifying band alignment of MOS2 and HBN. This effectuates a net charge transfer between MOS2 and HBN, indicating p-type character of MOS2. Now, this is the compact device modeling. The low energy dispersion near the Fermi level of graphene, which is placed on top of HBN, can be approximated as Ek equal to plus minus root of delta square plus h card Vfk whole square. Here plus signifies conduction band and minus signifies the valence band. Under parabolic, if we can assume this as a parabolic dispersion, then it becomes Ek equal to plus minus delta plus h card Vfk whole square by 2 delta. We have curve fitted this equation to the DFT data to check the consistency of the model. Now, incorporating the asymmetric band gap splitting in general, the conduction band and valence band formula are given in the slide. And here the band gap EGG that becomes delta GC plus delta GV. And using simple laws of physics, we can calculate the density states of graphene, density of states in graphene, that is the electron dose GGN and hole dose GGP. Continuing to the compact device modeling, the parabolic dispersion of MOS2 can be approximated as this equation, and similarly, that is the density of states in MOS2 can also be calculated as these formulas shown here. Now we have used the Fermi-Dirac distribution instead of the Boltzmann approximation, and upon this approximation, we get the intrinsic carrier concentrations of graphene and MOS2 as shown in the slide. And here we have referred all the band structure parameters in this figure. Upon application of gate voltage, the net charge carrier concentration in the graphene and MOS2 layers are shown via these equations. On the right hand side, there is the schematic diagram of the van der Waals structure based MESFET, and on the inset there is the coined device symbol. Now the equivalent electrostatic circuit of this structure becomes as shown in the slide. Here this model is this model consists of three capacitors in series, that is CQG, the quantum capacitance of graphene, CI, that is the insulator capacitance of HBN, and CQM, that is the quantum capacitance of MOS2. Now the total charge densities in the device becomes QG prime as Q into P net G minus N net G, and QI prime as Q into P net M minus N net M. And we have also got the potential balance equation as shown in the slide, and also the insulator voltage drop psi I equal to QG prime by CI prime. These all equations are needed to develop the compact device model of the structure. Now, using the charge balance equation formulated by Qg prime plus Qi prime equal to 0, this equation takes the form as shown in the as highlighted in the slide, and we have to solve this equation numerically to solve for psi s. Now, after getting the values of psi s and Qi prime, we get the quantum capacitance of graphene as shown in the figure, and also the formula is given, and also the quantum capacitance of MOS2 is obtained in a similar way. Both CQG and CQM operates within the quantum capacitance limit. Now, the total gate capacitance becomes a series of the quantum capacitance of graphene, the insulator capacitance of HBN, and the quantum capacitance of MOS2, and that profile is shown in the figure. Now, the drain current according to the drift diffusion formalism becomes IDC equal to this equation as shown in the slide. Now, the thing is that here the mobility mu here mobility is mu and D is the bias dependent diffusivity. Now, for conventional MOSFETs, for a given bias, Qi prime changes quasi linearly with psi s along the channel, and Qi prime is approximated as a linear function of psi s. However, in this case, due to the band gap opening of graphene, Qi prime is not necessarily maintains a linear dependence on psi s. Hence, we adopt the piecewise charge linearization technique to obtain a closed form analytical expression of current. In this technique, the whole channel is basically divided into smaller segments where Qi can be approximated as a linear function of psi s without invoking much error. After that, using the expression of drain current and the terminal charges are calculated using Ward-Dutton charge partitioning scheme and using those formulas shown in the figure. The compact model equations become as shown in the figure. We obtain the drain current, gate charge, drain charge, and source charge formulated as shown in the figure. Now, we plot the transfer characteristics and the drain characteristics of that MESFET structure. The transfer characteristics clearly points the threshold voltage increment of the MESFET with decreasing D1. However, the subthreshold slope remains constant with a swing of 60.48 millivolt per decade for all the cases. Now, we have implemented this model in SPICE using its Verilog AMS interface to conduct static and transient simulations of the integrated circuits. As shown in the figure, the SPICE engine assigns terminal voltages to the Verilog AMS module, which computes terminal charges and then returns them to the individual terminals to be further processed by the SPICE engine. Thus, in a nutshell, multiscale modeling methodology, we basically translate atomic level phenomena such as band gap opening in graphene or semiconductor doping in MOS2 to a circuit performance metric. This schematic representation captures this basic philosophy that bridges between the first principle based materials modeling tools and industry standard circuit simulators. Furthermore, this model could be adopted easily for conventional gate stack MOSFETs, and also several small geometry effects could easily be conjoined with it using standard pre-correction techniques. Henceforth, this stupendous flexibility and extreme scope of applicability encourages this model to stand high. Now, this is the logic inverter circuit that we have made using the SPICE. The voltage transfer characteristics of the logic inverter is shown. Here we can clearly see the threshold voltage shift due to the band gap opening in graphene, and using this logic inverters made out of those van der Waals heterostructure based MESFETs, we have developed 15 stage ring oscillator circuits, and its output waveform is shown in the figure. We can see here the change in the output frequency of the ring oscillator that happens mainly due to the band gap opening in graphene. Okay, thank you.